5 on your health now. More people are diagnosed with skin cancer every year in the U.S. than all other cancers combined.
We know that sunscreen protects against harmful UV rays, but recent studies have raised questions about what's in them.
And now some people are taking matters into their own hands, making their own sunscreen. A quick internet search turns up dozens of recipes for homemade sunscreen with ingredients like coconut oil and carrot seed essential oil. And a recent study in the journal Health Communication showed people are interested. One recipe on Pinterest was saved 21,000 times. But when researchers dug deeper, they found though most pins focused on the positives, 68.3% recommended recipes for homemade sunscreens that offered insufficient UV radiation protection.
It's very scientific and not something you can just cook at home.
Dr. Adam Wolkin is director of laser and cosmetic dermatology at Lahey Health. He says there's really no way to know the SPF of these recipes until you get burned.
The more sunburns you have over the course of your life, the risk of having a skin cancer increases exponentially.
Wolkin says if you're concerned about chemical sunscreens, choose a physical blocker instead.
I think the safest thing is to make sure that your sunscreen has at least zinc or titanium as the primary ingredient in it. You need to have at least a golf ball size from head to toe, and you need to make sure that you remember to reapply.
Make sure to do that every 2 hours. Also, choose a sunscreen that offers broad spectrum protection with an SPF of at least 30 in one product.
It's not additive, so having an SPF of 15 and then putting on another moisturizer with an SPF of 15 does not give you an SPF of 30.
Wolkin knows some of these sunscreens can be expensive, however.
The cost per wear is going to be a lot cheaper than going through a surgical procedure or multiple surgical procedures down the line.
Dr. Wolkin tells his patients to always wear sunscreen on their face, neck, ears. Don't forget your hands. They can get a lot of exposure through your windshield when you're in the car. We've linked some resources where you can compare sunscreen products on our website as well as on our WCBB mobile app.